Good morning! Welcome to the pottery on this beautiful Saturday morning. I wanted to share another kiln opening with you. And in my last video about the mosquitoes, my goodness, I'm already messing this up. About the multicolors Crafito turtle tumblers. I was hoping to get them through the next glaze firing, which is this one. Well, oh, you can't see them. Oh, they're still here. They haven't even gone through a glaze firing yet. I made some more, so that's why. They will be in the next or the one after. I have some other Crafito mugs in here, so, and you know, that's similar. But before I open the kiln, first things first. Oh, I break my reading glasses right off the bat. Good. I have a little note here. I want to say, muchas gracias, Cristina Cris. Cristina Cris wrote to me and asked me to please not turn off the subtitling. I didn't even know I had turned it off. So I did a little bit of research about the subtitles in YouTube. And you can put in a subtitle which is automatically generated in your own language. The way you do that, because, well, I didn't know this, so I thought maybe someone else out there who sees this doesn't know that either and might want to know how to do that. It's fairly easy, even for me. On the bottom right corner of the YouTube videos, you see some buttons. The second from the left is a square button. If you click that, it will get a little red stripe underneath, which means your subtitles are on. The next button next to that is where you can adjust the language you want it in. And I did that on one of my videos, and I had it set on Dutch. So it was translating my English blabbering into Dutch automatically. It's not perfect, but it works. I mean, yeah, I could follow. If I wasn't able to understand English, I could now at least understand it in Dutch. And sometimes it's just too funny. The roosters, they are mentioned in many of the videos as my live audience, you know. And when the translator picks up the sound of the roosters, it said in the subtitle, music. I thought that was hilarious. So you can, in any language, and thank you, Christina, for telling me. She's from Brazil, so she has her translator, I'm guessing, in Spanish. I'm not sure. So thank you. Speaking of roosters, just one more time. There are more. I have more live audience here from the animal kingdom. And I filmed them last week, so here is some more of beautiful Bonaire right outside my door. Hello there, internet friends. Here I am again. Some of you commented on the roosters they hear. It's my audience. Oh, doggies, please. But we have more visitors from the animal kingdom. Noah, shut your mouth. That's... These are very special donkeys. They are a certain breed that only lives here. They are absolutely beautiful. I don't know what I'm doing because the sun is shining in my camera. I hope you can see. They are very, very pretty. My dog doesn't like them. But hey. Aren't they cute? This is a better view, right? Hey, sweeties. Well, that's it for the animal kingdom of today. I'll see you in the next video. Okay. Let's get to the pottery business now. Kiln is about 40 degrees Celsius, so I'm fine now and I can open it up. Lots of different things this time. Cones, I have two sets of cones in here this time. This is the top shelf. Five. Oops, let's turn it over. And a six. It's almost the same as the last time. Five, well over. So it's past five, six starting to bend. Approximately cone 5.5, which is good. I'm taking this piece out first. This is from one of my students, Arvila. I'm trying Papiamento now, so don't laugh at me. Abo Birdbath Takla. This is the base of a birdbath. The birdbath dish is on a shelf somewhere down there, so I'll just take this out. One of my workshop attendees, her work is done. Good, experiment. There's always one or two experiments in there. New shape and a glaze combination. I absolutely love this. Look at this. It's an espresso cup. And I had, I experimented with Opulence Antique Iron, which is the brown one. And this is probably pearl white. Yeah, this is pearl white on top. These tiny cups are actually not easy to make. But I did three. I think I had six when I tried them. Three just, you know, were failures on the wheel, but I managed to create three with a trimmed foot ring. I like that glaze. Let's see what the others are. One shelf below. Let's take this out. More plant hangers. Tillandsia air plant hangers. And in not the last, but the one before that, I showed you. Oh, hold on. This would probably translate as music. That was a big truck. I was making or doing a first try on a landscape platter, the small one, and I wasn't happy with the pink yet. So I tried to combine Opulence Calico with Mako Raspberry to create a different pink. Still not the pink I'm after, but the combination is pretty. On this textured air plant hanger, Tillandsia hanger, there's a loop inside where you can hang your plant from, a hole here where you can put a rope, and if you hang your plant, it will look a little bit like a jellyfish. I have one more. That's the same glaze combination as the espresso cup, the antique iron and pearl white. I like that combination. That's not bad at all. Three. Okay. Some cookies. Always have cookies when you're experimenting. Says she, who knows that she didn't, but okay. We'll see. I guess this will be obvious if you look at it like this. Salt and pepper shaker. I have corks that fit in here. Hopefully. Oh, you know, I can check. Hold on, let me get some corks. I believe it's this one. If you have a cork that is tapered, it should almost always fit. Let's see. Oh gosh, no, it's the other cork. Sorry. It's the smaller one. Et voila. These are for the other salt and pepper shakers. There you go. What I did was I put the widest part on it and traced it, got that out. So after shrinkage, it would fit. Another truck. Gosh. You guys, it's Saturday. Take a day off. Salt and pepper. Norse blue with trailed pearl white. I like the effect. A kiln shelf to remove. Oh! Let's take out some posts. Arvila, your bird bath. This is hand-built. Let's take off the aluminum hydrate. Look what she did. She textured a slab and used some of my sprigs and stamps to put in a fish and a seashell. Gosh, that's pretty. This is the Blue Monday, which turns blue where it's thick and green where it's thin. Very nice. And it fits on her. Can you see? Where is my lid? The lid is in the way. It fits on the little stand. Well done. More espresso cups in a different place combination. Take the cookie off. This is also calico and raspberry mist. I like the combination, although not what I expected, but that's what happens in ceramics. Cute. I have a sister or a brother. Oh, that one's better. Or a brother. This has a little bit more raspberry mist on it, I think. Looks good. I hope the focus is better on this video. And more salt and pepper shakers. I think I showed you these pre-firing. That's the royal blue, the sapphire blue. And this one is fishes. Let's see if that cork fits. Yay! Another kiln shelf. And there is some more scruffy tofu coming up. This is a refire. Oh, that's better. This came out of a previous firing. It was okay, but I had some pinholing where the greenstone and the Norse bloom met. That has happened before. They probably don't like each other very well, but after a second firing, it all smoothed out. So this is a small bird feeder. I have a utensil crock, utensil holder, also sgraffito. This is in turquoise blue, just the turquoise blue. Turtles and fishes. I can just see this on somebody's kitchen sink with some, you know, some wooden spoons and things in there. They're a little bit thicker, they're a little bit sturdier, so you can, you know, really use them. More salt and pepper. This one is the same turquoise blue, but with daisies. Let's check. I believe that's this one too. Yep, fits perfectly. Cute. Oh, there are some more cones. Oh, look at that. Absolutely perfect. Five. Even bent over more. Six. And this tip is at the top of this triangle from these self-supporting cones. That's exactly the cone. So this is an exact cone six on the bottom. And that's the difference in temperature in this kiln. It just is. And that's why I put my mugs down there, because I do want to reach a cone six to fully vitrify the clay. There is one of them. The multicolor sgraffito turtles. One is already sold, pre-firing. So I'm going to have to send out some messages. There's another one. I'm starting to run out of room here. Okay. And one more. Again, multicolored, just three colors of blue. In the last video about the tumblers, it's the same. Oh, maybe that's fun to see. This is it pre-fired, and this is it when it's done. See how the colors change? You don't know what you have until it's place-fired in ceramics. And I have one more. In black and white. And there's a video of this one as well, where you can see how I sgraffito this. And somebody asked me if I had any difficulties with putting on the handle after putting on the slip. No, I put on the handle first and then the slip. I just try to carefully brush the slip around where the handle attaches. So there you go, another kiln opening. I think it's a good start of the weekend. I'm going to send out some messages for people who have already ordered and wanted some things. And I will be continuing my ceramic journey. If you like it, subscribe. If you have questions. Here we go again. If you have questions, don't hesitate. Please leave me a comment. I love to hear from you. I will see you in the next video. Bye for now.